Hello everyone, welcome to our special International Women's Day program. Our first feature is going to be about women's choices.
In 1897, Millicent Fawcett founded the National Union of Women Suffragists. Millicent believed that alongside a growing number of women that at the time, that women should have the right to vote. Millicent reasoned that amid backlash of disapproving men in Parliament, if women were expected to live by parliamentary rules, that they should have a say in how those laws were created. The suffragist movement torch eventually passed over to Emily Pankhurst and her daughters Christabel and Sylvia. They believed in more radical methods for change, and in 1905, Christabel Pankhurst and Annie Kenney interrupted a political meeting to ask Winston Churchill and Sir Edward Grey if they believed that women should have the right to vote. Not receiving a response, they waved a banner and demanded that men answer for the pertinent questions. They were arrested, and after refusing to pay any fines, they were put in prison for their actions. This set off a chain reaction, and eventually, in 1928, women were allowed to vote independently. Thanks to these brave women's persistence and sacrifices, women in the West have more freedom and are edging ever closer to complete equality. But there are still many places in the world where women are still far away from this milestone. A growing number of women in Iran are protesting against mandatory headscarves. They are tying headscarves on sticks and waving them around in public. This movement was known as the Girls of Revolution Street.
My name is Elnaz. I was born in Iran and growing up there. From age of 7, all females have to follow compulsory hijab law. And if they don't wear hijab, they are not able to get education and or get a job. There are many punishments for who don't wear headscarf. They can get arrested, they can get fined, or they can go into jail. I support the Girls of Revolution Street because I know they are not against Islam and they are not fighting just for a piece of fabric. They are fighting for their own dignity and their own identity. And I think they are looking for their freedom of choice.
With International Women's Day, a shining beacon of all that women have to offer and all the great things that have contributed to society, is a both a time to rejoice and to see how far women in the West have come, but also how we can help those in other countries with less freedom and equality for women.